I got an important topic to share with you this morning. Peace of God, God of peace. Peace of God with you and God of peace with you. Both are different. Peace of God with you, God of peace with you. So before I could bring God's word, I request Brother Joe to give the reading of the scriptures. That will be from Philippians chapter 1.
A reading from the book of Philippians 4 verses 1 to 9. Philippians 4 verses 1 to 9. Therefore, my brethren, dearly beloved and longed for, my joy and crown, so stand fast in the Lord, my dearly beloved. I beseech Euodias and beseech Syntyche that they be of the same mind in the Lord. And I entreat thee also, true yoke fellow, help those women which labored with me in the gospel, with Clement also, and with other my fellow laborers whose names are in the book of life. Rejoice in the Lord always, and again I say rejoice. Let your moderation be known unto all men. The Lord is at hand. Be careful for nothing, but in everything by prayer and supplication with thanksgiving let your requests be known unto God. And the peace of God, which passeth all understanding, shall keep your hearts and minds through Christ Jesus. Finally, brethren, whatsoever things are true, whatsoever things are honest, whatsoever things are just, whatsoever things are pure, whatsoever things are lovely, whatsoever things are of good report, if there be any virtue, and if there be any praise, think on these things. Those things which ye have both learned and received and heard and seen in me, do, and the God of peace shall be with you. Here ends the reading.
This morning, the caption is, God of peace with you. God of peace with you. Allow that you could keep your Bible open, and also this media person with a PowerPoint can cause the words on the screen, because I'm going to have a lot of reading today. Just reading my many Bible passages is preaching today. Philippians chapter 4 verse 1. Therefore, my brethren, dearly beloved and longed for, my brethren, dear brothers and sisters, dearly beloved and longed for, dearly longed for, my joy, dear brothers and sisters, Paul says, my joy, my crown, our joy, our crown. So stand fast in the Lord. Again he says, my dearly beloved. For God of peace to be with you. Number one, so stand fast. This way, stand fast. That little word so, in Greek it means this way, in this way, ippadiyaag, inda vidamaag, stand fast. So naturally we got a question, in which way, in what manner? For that we have to go to the previous verses. When Paul was writing, he didn't write chapter 1, chapter 2, chapter 3, chapter 4. It was just a long letter. Much later, it was divided into chapters and verses for better reference. To go to a specific passage, they wanted to have these chapters and the verses. By some Catholic priest it was done. It's only for our own convenience. But when Paul was not writing, he didn't say chapter 4, verse 1, chapter 4, verse 2, etc. So, ivvidamaga is so steadfast in the Lord. So, ivvidamaga, we go to the previous passage, chapter 3 from verse 17. Chapter 3, verse 17. Brethren, be followers together of me, and mark them which walk so as you have as for an example, for an ensample. Paul says, my dearly beloved brother, sister, who is our joy, who is our crown, please be followers together of me as I follow Christ. Follow Christ with me. If you are in this fellowship, a God of peace to be with you, follow Christ with me, be followers with me, with us. And mark them which walk so as you have as for an ensample. So we have shown some people as example. They walk as we have preached. Many people walk. They walk in a different way. Not as we have preached. Not as we have preached. They walk in a different way. They preach in a different way. About grace, they may have a different doctrine. About worldliness, they may have a different doctrine. About godliness, they may have a different doctrine. About tithing, they may have a different doctrine. About the Lord's Day, they may have different doctrine. Don't walk behind them. Don't walk behind them. Mark them who walk so as you have us for an ensample. Those who are walking as we have preached, mark those saints. I can say, those who are walking as per the word of God, mark them. Mark them. Don't come and tell me, hey, he's singing dingri dingale, dingri dingale. Many youth are attracted. Why should not hear dingri dingale? No, don't go behind them. So and so says, oh, don't give a tithing to the church. Send your tithing to our TV program. Don't go behind them. Mark them. Those who are walking as we are preaching. At any point of time, Paul didn't say that, I add to it. If you feel this teaching is wrong, you can come and talk with me. And you can try to explain to me where I am wrong. And if you can't do it, and if you are minded otherwise, I encourage you, join the group which suits you. Don't try to have two leadings. You will be the sufferers. So as far as our church is concerned, worship is not entertainment. Worship is not entertainment. In our church, music is only to discipline us, support us, to lead us in our singing unto the Lord, so that we will be able to sustain our pitch, so that we will be able to keep up the rhythm. We all can have one rhythm. So my concept of music and worship is only to help singing. Certainly I cannot imagine a music dominating singing. Can you understand? So we had guitar, bass guitar, lead guitar, rhythm guitar, no doubt about it. We have got drum set, the other equipment, tabla, triple gango, good. We all had all those things. Even now the Lord can bring committed people, we love to have them. So we are not against music. But the very purpose of music is to keep the rhythm and the pitch. It's not a musical concert. So our idea of worship is not an entertainment. We sing unto the Lord, not sing unto the audience. We sing unto the Lord, we don't sing unto audience. The worship leader or the choristers, they lead the worship. They don't give a solo performance. They lead the worship that we all can sing unto the Lord. Why explain this? There may be saints, say take A.W. Tozer. He has written a book on worship and entertainment. Today people are unable to differentiate between real worship and entertainment. So here Paul says, mark them who walk so as you have as for an example. We are told to take this person as an example. Take them as an example. Mark them and walk accordingly. Where he gives the reason for many walk. Because many people do ministry. Many walk. Not only Robert Simon. Many walk, of whom I have told you often. Not only today. I have told you often. Now tell you, even weeping. With real broken heart. With a burden for my dearly beloved. With a burden for who are of joy and crown. With weeping. With real burden I tell you that they are the enemies of the cross of Christ. Those servants of God, those ministers, they are walking. They are doing some ministry. But they are enemies not of Christ. They are not enemies of Christ. They are enemies of the cross of Christ. The cross of Christ. They want the blessings of Christ. They preach there is no cross. Their preaching is different from the preaching of Jesus Christ. Jesus said, if you want to follow me, take up your cross and follow me. They preach, if you go to Jesus, there is no cross. They said, Jesus said, you shall have tribulation in this world. They say, oh, we shall have no tribulation at all. Their gospel is different from the gospel of Jesus Christ. They are not enemies of Christ. But they are enemies of the cross of Christ. Whose end is destruction. Whose end is destruction. Their path is very successful. Very attractive. But their end is destruction. Whose God is their belly. They want to preach anything and everything so that they could gather crowd and they'll get more income. More crowd, more income. One more family, today easily it is 2,000, 3,000 or even 5,000 would be their monthly income. One more family. Their God is their belly. They go for preaching. They got rates. If I had to preach in a Sunday morning service, this is the rate. If I had to give a very eloquent talk in a wedding, this is the rate. If I had to preach in a convention, this is the rate. Even today, this type of that so-called worship leaders, they are more than worship leaders. They are disco jockeys. These disco jockeys have got different tariff. If they are invited to sing in a wedding, this is the tariff. They are invited to sing in the reception, this is the tariff. If they are invited to sing in the Sunday service, this is the tariff. To sing in a convention, this is the tariff. They to conduct a concert, this is the tariff. My dear brother, my dear sister. Their God is belly. they won't see power in the cover they receive. You want to follow them? With weeping, I tell you. With weeping, I tell you. Their God is their belly, whose glory is in their shade. Is in their shade. For anything, everything is based on the business. If you can pay more money, they can scream and sweat. If you pay less money, they'll sing a gentle solo and finish. Their service is proportionate to their income, whose glory is in their shade. Very interestingly, I had a shock in Warangal. After one of the meetings, my translator from English to Telugu, he came and asked me, "Pastor, if I invite you, will you come to our church?" I said, "Surely I'll come." "Our church is a small church." I said, "No problem. Where the Lord gives an opening to share the truth, I'll be going there, no problem, big or small." Then he asked another question that shocked my life. "What is the advance?" Huh? I said, "What advance?" Again said, "How much advance you need?" I said, "Has it gone so bad? Should they take advance and book the meetings?" He said, "Pastor, what do you mean by this?" "No, no, how advance I must tell you." So what he meant, how early he should fix me. I said, "No problem. When you get ready with the meeting, you contact me. If I'm available, I come. There's no need that you have to tell me 1 year before, 2 years before." Today, their shame is their glory. Their glory is their shame. And mind earthly things. What should be the, how many wall posters, whether banners, cutouts, what should be the gathering? Some, there are some star preachers, if they are invited to preach, how many people will be coming? What is the arrangement? Where do we stay? We stay in a big hotel. So many restrictions. The same people, when they want to go to the Middle East, they don't ask any question. They go to the Middle East from one church, they phone to another pastor. "Pastor, nanga vandirukkira unga church ku vandittu pallama." At times it sounds that as if they are more than beggars. With a real pain, I tell you. Here, you ask so many questions. What would be the size of the crowd? How many wall posters? How many handbills? When they go to Middle East, they don't ask all the questions. They don't say, "We'll stay in a hotel." Mostly they stay in the houses. Houses of that pastor. They share that house. Here they can't share the house of the pastor. Very truly I tell you, please don't follow them. Don't follow them. There are people, they mind only earthly things, posters, banners, crowd. Why don't they ask it in Saudi? Just go for one round, you can come here with 2 lakhs. Minimum. For star preachers, it may be 10 lakhs. My dear brother, my dear sister. Verse 20, "For our conversation is in heaven, from where also we look for the Savior, the Lord Jesus, who shall change our vile body, that it may be fashioned like unto the glorious body, according to the working whereby He is able even to subdue all things unto Himself." So our objective is different, to make people ready for the Lord. One day somebody brought a handbill to me. It's a fasting prayer. We will pray that you will get a new house, your own house. We'll pray that we'll get you a own house. When I saw that, I very laughingly told that brother, if you want to get a new house, an own house, you go to that prayer meeting. If you want to have a house in heaven, come here. If you want to have a mansion in heaven, come here. If you want to own a house on the earth, go there. With this, he says in the next verse, stand fast, so stand fast in the Lord. So stand fast in the Lord. With an idea that I should go to heaven, let not your God be your belly. Let not your glory be shame. Let not you be earthly minded. So stand fast in the Lord. God of peace shall be with you. Number 2. Verse 2. I beseech Euodias and beseech Syntyche. I remember some years back, I preached on Euodias and Syntyche. They are two co-workers of Paul, those who labored much with Paul, Euodias and Syntyche, that they be of the same mind in the Lord. Now, problem with Euodias and Syntyche, they could not have one mind. Both are Christians, both are co-workers of Paul, leaders in the church, but they could not have one mind. So the second thing, be of one mind, husband and wife, be of one mind. Parents and children, be of one mind. Co-bonds, be of one mind. Believers in the church, be of one mind. Sunday school teachers, be of one mind. Youth leaders, be of one mind. Volunteers, be of one mind. If you are not in one mind, the headache is for the pastor. If a husband and wife are not of one mind, problem is for the children. If the children are not of one mind, problem is with the parents. Problem is for the parents. So when Euodias and Syntyche, servants of God, when they are not of one mind, it's a problem for the church. How can we have one mind? Again, I read a little longer passage. Chapter 1. We shall go to verse 27 and 28. Chapter 1. Probably this was the problem in that elite church. It was an elite church. A good spiritual church. But there were problems in that spiritual church. In chapter 1, verse 27, he says, let our conversation be as it becometh of the gospel of Christ. Let our behavior among the volunteers, behavior in a Christian family, behavior in the church, let your behavior be as it becometh the gospel of Christ. In a way that it could suit the gospel of Christ. We are Christians. Let our behavior proclaim that we are Christians. That it becomes the gospel of Christ. That whether I come and see you or else be absent, I may hear of your affairs, that you stand that in one spirit, with one mind, striving together for faith of the gospel. It's a very powerful passage. Husband and wife, if you have to strive together கூடி போராடி. You should not strive against one another. You should not fight against one another. You have to fight together against evil. You have to fight not against one another. You have to fight together against the enemy, against the evil one. To fight against the evil one, husband and wife must have one spirit. Sunday school teachers must have one spirit. Sunday school teachers with pastor, they must have one spirit. The servants of God have a different spirit, and Sunday school teachers different spirit. It will not work out. It will not work out. That will form cancer. What is cancer? Many times we don't understand cancer. Cancer is an erratic cell. Cancer is an erratic cell that will not take the commands of the brain. That will act independently. It's not a dead cell. It is an erratic cell. It doesn't take the command from the brain, from the center. The evil part of that not only doesn't take command from the center, it will gather many cells to it. It will gather many cells to it. As we say, a paambu puttu, erumbu puttu. So this one erratic cell will gather many cells and it will form a puttu inside. That's why in Tamil we call that puttu noi. It will form a puttu inside, an abscess. Why? It is of a different spirit. If a volunteer and an active volunteer, he refuses to take control from the center and he or she wants to act on her own, and he or she gathers other people not to work to the center, she is or he is forming cancer within the body. The first thing, one mind. Even between Yodhyas and Sintaki, there must be one mind. There must be one mind. That must be in one spirit. We should, not only the Holy Spirit, we should work with that one spirit. A great philosopher said, the whole body cannot have eye. The whole body cannot have eye. Only the head will have the eye. Only the head will have the eye. And they will perceive things. In that direction, those who are helping them should go with them. That's a very simple logic for any organization, very much for that matter a church, to go forward. Everybody has got eye, then everybody will be going in a different direction. Everybody will be going in a different direction. If a pastor has got an idea that we should not make collection for this particular purpose, and another, no, we should make a collection for this, I will do the collection for this. So that person is acting against the vision of the pastor. It's a question which is right or which is wrong, but when you work against the head, you'll become cancerous. So first, it's not a question whether Yodhyas and Sintaki, they are doing ministry or not. Are they in one spirit? So better they could join the people, those who got the same spirit. That's the best thing, and it's all the more better to do it early. They join the people, those who got the same spirit. The final day it will be a judgment, who is right, who is wrong. So they are workers, co-workers, but they don't have one spirit. So Paul says, the formula to get one mind, they must have one spirit. So very powerfully he says, with one spirit, that one spirit must develop one mind. That you stand fast in one spirit, with one mind, one thinking process. Pastor said this is not good. That leader thinks, okay, this is not good. One mind. Oh, Pastor Kvara Valiella. Summa Pastor Buddhan Soluar. Avlanama Sayam Mudyat. So they are with a different mind. They are with a different mind. It's a very simple thing. Are you one, with a one mind? Are you got a different mind? Or the Sunday school teacher says, we'll do like this. We can't do like that. Then the Sunday school superintendent and that teacher, they are not in one mind. They are with two different minds. They cannot work together. They cannot work together. And media, somebody is leading. And he says that we must get this done like this. And somebody working under him says, no, no, it is not necessary, we need not do like this. They are not in one mind. So the leader says, we must have an ID card. We all must have an ID card. You operate camera, why that ID is necessary? Without ID card, I can operate. Possible. But they are not in one mind. They are working together. They are not in one mind. So the devil will cause a division, a small thing, whether to wear an ID card or not. The Sunday school superintendent says, oh, we must start the class at 10 o'clock. The English medium start at 10 o'clock. That all I can't come. I have to talk with different people. Only on Sunday we meet. I can come late. So that Sunday school superintendent and the teacher, they are not of one mind. That will make a shipwreck. That will bring curses in that ministry they are doing. Because they are not one mind. So with the pastor or with the people, those who lead different groups, they must have one mind. One who is in charge of the loafers, he says we have to put salt. The other person says, no, no, we need not put salt, we have to put sugar. How beautiful. No, no, I'll put salt. No, no, we'll put sugar. They are not in one mind. The broth will be spoiled. So for us to be successful, we must be one mind. To have one mind, we must have one spirit. Otherwise it will become cancerous. And immediately he'll gather two or three boys against the leader of the media. He'll gather two or three boys who would be against the head of the law feast or the superintendent of Sunday school. She'll gather two or three teachers. That gathering is the cancer. That gathering is the cancer. At times we can save if the amputation is done at the earliest. Otherwise it will spread. It's a very simple, it's not to talk about any individual. Same thing in your family. The mother wants to correct the child. The father is against it. The father wants to correct the child. Mother is against it. The child is spoiled. So to have one mind. So verse 28. And in nothing terrified by your adversaries, whatever the situation may be. I want to have one mind with my husband. I'm not worried about any problem. I want to have one mind with my wife. Nothing else. I want to have one mind in my group. I want to have one mind with my leader. I want a one mind with my pastor. So here it says, nothing terrified by your adversary. I am not worried about anything else. I'm not trying to please somebody. Somebody wants to please the cancer cell. They want to show more love to the cancer cell than the active cell. This is the great burden. This is the great problem in the society. They got more soft corner for the cancer cell. So here it says, nothing terrified by your adversaries, which is to them an evident token of perdition. Amma appa one mind da. Appa sonna amma yes, amma sonna appa yes. That will be a protection for your child from perdition. Any ministry, they are one mind, not terrified by adversaries, that is an evident token. Otherwise, it will lead to perdition. But to you of salvation and that of God, if we are with one spirit, with one mind, that is to us a victory, a deliverance. This salvation is not salvation from sin, salvation from shipwreck, salvation from perdition. And that salvation, that deliverance comes of God. So he continues from verse 1, chapter 2. If there be therefore for any consolation in Christ, any comfort of love, if any fellowship of the Spirit, if any bowels of mercies, fulfill ye my joy, that you be like-minded, having the same love, be of one accord, of one mind. Don't think that my husband should be the source of my consolation. Don't think my wife must be the source of my consolation. Don't think that my pastor should understand me. Don't think my believers should understand me. If you want any consolation, you've got your consolation in Christ. Whether your husband is a source of consolation or not, whether your wife is a source of consolation or not, whether your husband understands or not, wife understands or not, my consolation is in Christ. My comfort of love is in Christ. If anybody wants to work with me, that word fellowship, here it means giving shoulders. Thol kudukkanunna. Enak andha believer help pannala, indha teacher enna help pannala, andha cook panna varava illa, media ki eduthu vekka varava illa. It's all unnecessary rubbish thing. Unakku thol kudukka yaar irukkara? If the Holy Spirit gives you shoulder, work with that. The Holy Spirit gives fellowship. It's not the husband will pay, give the shoulder, wife will give a shoulder. No, you've got any fellowship of the Holy Spirit? If any bowels and mercies, whether others feel sorry for you, whether others are compassionate towards you, whether others are compassionate or not, whether they just churn with, oh, you suffer like this. 99% that will be the voice of the devil. Oh, you are suffering like this. Your husband is not taking care. This is not allowed. This is the voice of the devil. Oh, your wife is not at all understanding you. Devil is talking to you. Only one person should show bowels of mercies. Christ, enough. Mattonga kaatra yerakkam ella 199 pey pesudhu. யோ பிரதர், எப்படி கஷ்டப்படுறீங்க? உங்க வீட்டில் என்ன கவனிக்கவே மாட்டாங்களா? உடனே நீங்க என்ன சொல்ல, இயேசுவின் நாமத்தில் போபிசாசி சபிக்கிறேன் அப்படின்னு சொன்னீங்கன்னா தப்பிச்சிங்க. நீங்களும் கூட சேர்ந்து அழுதிங்கன்னா உங்க குடும்பம் கெட்டு போயிடும், நாசமாக போயிடும், உங்க குடும்பம் நாசமாக போயிடும். We must have bowels of mercies only from Jesus. He has got bowels of mercies for us. அப்படியே அவருடைய குடல் நமக்காக உருகுது. அவர் மனதுருக்கம் உள்ள தெய்வம். மற்ற வெண்ணெயெல்லாம் உருக வேணாம். மற்ற வெண்ணெயெல்லாம் உருகுனா நீங்கள் நாசமாக போயிடுவீங்க. உங்கள் முன்னால் உருகுவாங்க, வெளியே போய் கமெண்ட் அடிப்பாங்க. ஸோ ஹியர் ஹி சேஸ், இஃப் தேர் பி எனி கான்சலேஷன் இன் கிரைஸ்ட், எனி கம்ஃபர்ட் ஆஃப் லவ் இன் கிரைஸ்ட், இஃப் எனி ஃபெலோஷிப் ஆஃப் த ஸ்பிரிட், இஃப் எனி பவல்ஸ் அண்ட் மர்சிஸ் ஆஃப் த ஸ்பிரிட், ஃபுல்ஃபில் ஈ மை ஜாய். The joy of the pastor, the joy of Paul, the joy of Christ, the joy of the head of the family or the head of any group. Fulfill ye my joy, Euodias and Syntyche, that ye be like-minded, having the same love, being of one accord. Thank God that we are stopping with one instrument. Guitar in one pitch, keyboard in another pitch, violin is another pitch. எல்லாம் பிச்சுட்டு போயிடும். தேர் கான் பி ஒன் அக்கார்ட். இஃப் யூ டோன்ட் ஹவ் ஒன் மைண்ட், யூ கான்ட் ஹவ் ஒன் அக்கார்ட். யூ நோ ஒன் திங், யூ ஆர் பிளேயிங் அன் இன்ஸ்ட்ருமெண்ட். சே பிரதர் யுவராஜ் இஸ் பிளேயிங் இன்ஸ்ட்ருமெண்ட். இஸ் யுவராஜ் பிளேயிங் இன்ஸ்ட்ருமெண்ட் ஆர் இஸ் ஃபிங்கர்ஸ் பிளே இன்ஸ்ட்ருமெண்ட்? விச் இஸ் பிளேயிங் இன்ஸ்ட்ருமெண்ட்? நீங்கள் வாசிக்கிறீங்களா, உங்கள் கை வாசிக்குதா? நீங்க தான் வாசிக்கிறீங்க. அவருடைய மைண்டு, அவருடைய மைண்டு. அவர் பக்கத்தில் இன்னொருத்தன் கீபோர்டு வாசிக்கும், அவன் மைண்ட் வேற மாதிரி இருக்கு. அப்புறம் கை எப்படி வாசிக்கும்? மைண்ட் ஒன்னா தான் கை ஒன்னா. மைண்ட் ஒன்னாகுது, கை ஒன்னாகலன்னா டாக்டரை போய் பார்க்கணும். ஏதோ நர்வ் ப்ராப்ளம், ஏதோ நர்வ் ப்ராப்ளம். How can we have one accord if we have one mind? If we are like-minded, having the same love, be of one accord, of one mind. Let nothing be done through strife or vain glory, but in lowliness of mind, let each esteem other better than themselves. Esteem other better than themselves. Look not for every man of his own things, but every man also of the things of others. And the better thing, look for the things of the group. The wife should not be worried about her problems. The husband should not be worried about his problems. They should be worried about the family. If the wife is worried about her problems and the husband is worried about his problems, they may get it, but the family is ruined. So every believer in a church, including the servants of God, their interest is in the institution. Their interest is in the church, the fellowship. It is not the individuals. Individuals make institutions, and institutions will not make individuals. If the individuals are good, the institution is good. Institution is non-living. Individuals are living. The word family, family is non-living. Husband, wife, father, mother, children, brother, sister, daughter-in-law, son-in-law, family is by the individuals. The individuals are dead, not like-minded, the family will be dead, suffering. The family cannot make individuals good. Father may make the children good. Mother may make the children good. But when they all are good, the family is good. Please remember, family is a word. The members of the family make it lively. The human beings make an organization lively. The church is a living thing. How can we make the church a living thing? Church is a word. Church church is a word. But the member of the church, members of the church, make the church good or make the church bad, make the church apolitical, make the church spiritual. The church itself cannot function spiritual. A church itself cannot function spiritual. The members of the church can make that fellowship spiritual, apolitical, or carnal. Only they can make it. So he says, let this mind be in you, which was also in Christ Jesus. We have to read up to verse 11. I don't have time to read. My dear brother, my dear sister, so please remember the Philippians chapter 4 verse 3. We don't know to whom this was written. The name is not given. Probably the pastor in charge of the church at that time. We got the names of Euodias, Syntyche, but we don't have the name of the person to whom Paul wrote that letter. In verse 3 he says, I entreat thee also. We don't know the recipient. We don't know the recipient. We can give a name to the recipient. We can say, I entreat Joe also. Or we can say, I entreat, and put some other name, also. What that I entreat you? That you, yoke fellow. So that brother, he is an yoke fellow. He tells them, help those women. Help Euodias and Syntyche. Help those women which labored with me in the gospel. The beauty of the thing, Euodias and Syntyche, they worked with Paul in the gospel. They are saved, born again, baptized. They worked with Paul in the gospel. But now there is a problem with Euodias and Syntyche. So he is asking the third person, the recipient of this letter, maybe the leader of that fellowship, I entreat you. He says, I beg you. Suppose I write a letter like this. I use the name Joe. I just write a letter. Joe, I beg you, Joe. For what I beg you? Help these women. These Euodias and Syntyche. Help these women which labored with me in the gospel. With Clement also. So when they were helping Paul in the gospel, Clement was also there. And with other my fellow laborers, whose names are in the book of life. So they are with a team of leaders. Now there's a problem between them. So what he says, the third person, please help them. Make them understand. Nowadays some people, when there is a problem between two, they will add fire to the fuel. They will see the bonfire. They add nice fuel. They'll make sure that it will not die. They'll make sure it will not die. That should not be the work of the other believers in the church. There's a beautiful essay by Robert Lind. Quench the fire at once. Quench the fire at once. You must be able to quench the fire at once. So he's asking the third person, that must be one mind in the church. Everybody must endure for that. Then God of peace be with you. I go quickly to number 4. Rejoice in the Lord always. Verse 4, Philippians 4, 4. And again I say, rejoice. Be joyful. Try to take the positive side of every situation. Euodias, rejoice in the Lord. Don't be worried about what Syntyche has done. Syntyche, rejoice in the Lord. Don't take much of what Euodias has done. Rejoice in the Lord always, Euodias, Syntyche. And again I say, rejoice. So be joyful in every situation. Recently, I saw a small anecdote, an illustration in one of the WhatsApp postings. A young boy was scolding an old man very badly, bitterly, But the old man was taking it up and he was smiling. So somebody who saw that asked that old man, "See, that young fellow is scolding you like this. Are you not angry? How is that you are able to put up a smile?" The old man said, "I'm happy he's not beating me. I'm happy he's not beating me. Had he beaten you up, I'll be happy that he has not killed me. Has he killed you? Then also I'll be happy, at least he has given me deliverance from this world." So in every situation he's able to see how he could be happy. So here it is, it's a chapa matter. Try to be happy. Because he is scolding you, praise God, at least he's not hitting you. Husband must be happy about it. My wife is only scolding. He's not hitting me, praise God. You must be able to take joy in everything. Then we can rejoice always. Let me go a little fast. Number four. Let your moderation be known to all. Verse 5. Let your moderation be known unto all men. The Lord is at hand. In Tamil, that word moderation is translated as shantagunam. Shantagunam. You must have a shantagunam like the shantagunam of Jesus. You know the shantagunam of Jesus at one point is able to call Peter apale pasatane. He can tell Peter apale pasatane. You must have that shantagunam. It is not only the shantagunam that says, that calls Judas, "My friend." He was not calling Peter, "My friend." He said, "Appalepa Satta." We must have the shantagunam to take the whip. To take the whip. Jesus is Shanta Swarupi. If we give a Swarupam to Shantam, if we make a murti to Shantam, if we make a murti to, if we make an idol to Shantam, Jesus would come. We sing Shanta Swarupiye. Shanta Swarupi must be able to take whip. So what is this Shantam here? This Shantam is not putting up no resistance. That's not the Shantam. Putting up no resistance is not shanta. The literal meaning for that Greek word is, in Tamil we can say, yerpudaya. Yerpudaya. That moderation is appropriate. That's the exact meaning for that Greek word. Appropriateness. If you have got an accessibility to Greek lexicon, for this word moderation you will find appropriateness. You should not be angry more, you should not be angry less. You must have an appropriate reaction. The reaction should not be based on your hurts, the reaction must be based on the evil that has taken place. That should be seen to all. Nobody should say that you are angry too much, or that nobody should say that you are upusapilladad. Allah upu potu thingyana, enna potu thingyana, unarchiye illappa. No, we are not that. Our reaction to any evil situation must be appropriate. It must be appropriate. So the literal meaning is, in every situation you work out in an appropriate way. You're correcting your children in an appropriate way. You behave with respect to others in an appropriate way. You talk to people of other sex in an appropriate way. When an evil takes place, your reaction is, it's an appropriate way. And it says the Lord is at hand. And it got a deeper meaning. It's not that Jesus is coming back soon. The literal meaning is, the Lord is there. they are doing evil to you, the Lord will take care of you. You need not overact. Okay, that's a better expression. You need not overact. The Lord is there. The Lord is nearby. The Lord will take care of you. You just do what the Lord says. The Lord will be able to dictate you. The Lord will be able to help you. The Lord will tell you what you should speak, how you should react or proact. Let your moderation be known to all men. The Lord is at hand. God of peace shall be with you. Number 5, verses 6 and 7. Be careful for nothing. Let not be careless. In today's English, we could understand. Be not worried, overcooked. Better, be not anxious about anything. Don't be anxious about anything. Faith and fear cannot coexist. If you have got faith, you can't have fear. If you have got fear, you don't have faith. Don't be anxious for anything. But in everything, by prayer and supplication with thanksgiving, let your requests be made known to God. And the peace of God, which passeth all understanding, shall keep your hearts and minds through Christ Jesus. The peace of God. God of peace is different from peace of God. Peace of God. Peace of God be with you. It will rain your hearts and minds. What is raining the heart? What is raining the mind? They are different. It will keep your hearts and minds through Christ Jesus. So don't be perturbed. Don't be anxious. What to eat? What to dress? Where to live in? What will be our future? Don't be very anxious. The Lord knows. The Lord knows that you need all these things. Till this day, I lack no good thing. Not one day I suffer for food. Many people say, if you go to ministry, you may not have anything to eat. Not one day I suffered. Not one day I was stranded without a shelter. Not one day I was without dress. There were difficult situations. We remember the days that only one set of uniform for Christy and Hepsi. One set for Christy, one set for Hepsi. Every evening they would come back from school. It's the work of your pastor ma to get those cloths washed, dried. And every morning is my duty to iron it. They went to school very neat. Nobody knew they had only one set of uniform. Had they known, many people would have come forward to get uniform. Our relatives, our co-bonds, they all are in well-off position. Sisters are mine. Our co-bonds are in well-off position. Had they known that Christy didn't have uniform, a change of a set of uniform, our Hepsi doesn't have a set of change of uniform, they all would have bought. Had my pastor known, he would have bought us. God called us for the ministry. We didn't allow pastor or relatives to know about it. But I can honestly tell you, there was not one single day they are not without uniform. That's the miracle. When I came for the ministry, I had only one set of white pants and white kurta. But that time the Lord provided a tailor for us to be a caretaker here. In those days they sit on the floor. I sit very carefully. I change my legs from this side to that side. I'll hear, trr, 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 trr. I know my pants is getting torn. I'll keep my jippa in a way that the torn part is not seen. So that Monday he'll have it stitched. Again next Sunday, trr, trr, trr. But there was not one Sunday without dress. When there was not an alternative dress, at least he has given a tailor to help me. That's the beauty. It's not to get anybody's sympathy, I'm saying that. We have seen all those parts. But we know the Lord has never forsaken us. The Lord has never forsaken us. Then the peace of God will keep us through Christ Jesus, our mind and heart. The peace of God. All peace that passeth all. And how's that? I was in a very good job. Resigned the job. Came for the ministry. This was the situation. Our peace was not disturbed. It was kept by the... This is the peace that passeth all understanding. When we came for the ministry, almost the other day, sister was to go to a nearby small petty shop, buy that mor malaga, a gurga, kakilo arisi, 100 milli enna. With that 50 rupees what we got, we had to buy only that. Only we had rice and we were able to make something. Even there was a difficult situation, we could not get rice, only kakilo arisi. One evening sister came and told me, I have said this example many a time, but these are the things which I'm making a stand firm in the Lord. One afternoon sister came and told me, I'm feeling very shy to go and ask for kakilo arisi and all. Why can't we keep some money and buy ration arisi? Ration arisi is not wrong, but we never have been exposed to it. I never knew where the ration shop was. I said, when we can't buy even ration rice, God will send us biryani rice. For the glory of the Lord, I tell you, in 20 minutes' time, a bag of nice ponni arisi came. And the next morning, one full bag of ponni arisi came. We didn't know what to do with that much of rice. And we sent that rice to many people, those who are in need. And till this day, maybe from 85, that must be July, August in 85, till this day, not one day we suffer. In our church we are able to have a love feast every Sunday. Every month we are able to have a love feast for pastors' fellowship. Every month we are able to have a beautiful banquet in the pastors' prayer fellowship. My God is great. Let your request be known to God. Don't be anxious about anything. Don't be anxious about anything. We know zero, but we have never seen less than zero. Our God is great. And to save time, let me go a little fast. Number 6, verse 8, finally. This finally doesn't mean this is the last one. Above all, I said so many things, finally. Brethren, beloved brethren, beloved and longed for, dear, our joy and our crown. Finally, brethren, whatsoever things are true, whatsoever things are honest, whatsoever things are just, whatever things are pure, whatsoever things are lovely, whatsoever things are of good report, if there be any virtue, and if there be any praise, think on these things. I want to explain everything. God willing, we'll have it for some other time. Now I tell you only one thing. Think on. It's not think. Think on. Continually meditate. Let your frame of mind be. Let your thought process be. It's more to do with the psychology, this whole subject. Let your thought process be on noble things. The thinking makes a man. You're what you think. You're what you think. There was a old comic one. One of the comic actors, you stand before the mirror and you will be continually saying, I am a dog, I am a dog, I am a dog, I am a dog. After a few times, he will start barking. He starts running with four legs. You go on, what's that you are thinking, you will be. What's that you are thinking, you will be. So think on noble things. Think on noble things, the thought process. Think on. It's a process. Not think. Think on. It's a process. And finally, the seventh point, Philippians 4:9. Here only he says, God of peace will be with you. Those things which your death learned and received and heard and seen in me, Paul has got the right and the authority to say that. I love that God's grace should be bestowed upon me, that I should be in a position to say that with all humility, at least in a miniature level. As a servant of God, the Lord has given me. I tell you this in two phases. Phase number one, those things which you have learned from me. You might have learned certain things from me. Otherwise, I'm not a fit to be a pastor. If you can't learn from your leader, well, you would be able to remember certain areas, certain disciplines. Even the other day I was telling a person how much I learned from my father. How much I learned from my father. The things which you have learned in me, not from me, and received. So many teachings you might have received. How you should be punctual. How you should plan. What is tithing for me? How do I tithe? How much I am blessed because of that? What do you receive? How that I want to honor Sabbath? Many times I might have told you from the time that I got saved. Only one day I went for my examination. What do you heard from me? When I was sitting in the examination hall, that for group 2, very easily I passed group 3. But I didn't go for a job, I continued with my studies. Now it's group 2. 100% I knew that I could pass. The ability the Lord has given me. But in the examination hall I thought, is it right to be here on the Lord's day, just writing for a worldly exam? I felt as if maybe a few months since I got saved. I felt very bad. I want to do something. I may be mad. There was a question on pessimism, optimism, and pragmatism. It is in my philosophy paper. I wrote from Paul, setting up a goal to win Christ. How I should run. I wrote a message. Few months since I got saved. And another passage. As an answer to the question, I wrote my full testimony. Very solemnly I love. It's in God's hand. I love to meet the person who would have corrected my paper. I do believe I would meet him in heaven. If it's the grace of God that I could meet him earlier, I would be happy. I wrote my full testimony. I came out. There's the only one day I missed the Lord's service because of my public examination. There's another occasion, it was Saturday, when there has been a prayer meeting in the church. It was very busy, busy ministry work, tuitions. One Saturday, that Saturday I was free. So with our children, we went for a trade fair. We'll be just checking in around 6:30 or so. Somehow our heart pricked. And pastor will be kneeling down praying. Can I be in a trade fair? Immediately we came out of the trade fair. We took an auto, came to Purasawalkam. We joined the prayer meeting. So you have received from me. You heard from me. You have seen. The third one he says, and seen in me what you have learned from your servants. So in our preaching, many times we share our testimony. Testimony about marriage. Testimony about choosing a person. Testimony how you both serve the Lord in the Sunday school. By the grace of God, your pastor is able to share their testimonies, their personal life, not only preaching. So what you have both learned, received, and heard, and seen in us, do. Pastor Marla varad. No. If we can do, and if we can do so, that's a logical conjunction. If you do this, and as a result of it, the God of peace shall be with you. The God of peace shall be with you. You want to be worldly and don't take this as an excuse. I tell you Philippians 1:7 and conclude. Even as it is meet for me to think this of you, as it is meet for me. Meat means don't think biryani. As it is suitable, as it matches. Even as it is meet for me to think this of you, to think this of you, of you all, this of you all, the boys, girls, brothers, sister, this of you all. Because I have you in my heart, in as much as both in my bonds. I have you in my heart, and I have in my bonds, and in the defense and confirmation of the gospel. What is that I have of you? You all, everybody, from one who stands with me here on the dais and somebody stands at the rear. You all are partakers of my grace, the grace given unto me. You are here in this church because the grace given unto your pastor. This also I said many a time. I say this and conclude. At that time our church may have approximately some 600-700 believers. And not even that much. There's some, I mean maybe 200-300 at the upstairs. Smaller than this. Upstairs smaller than this place. There are some 50-60 children in the Sunday school. Your pastor ma was in the Sunday school. I was a special teacher in the Sunday school. Every Sunday I'll be taking a special lesson. We were in the Sunday school. Her brother was my friend. In the presence of God, I tell you, we didn't know each other. I didn't know her name. We were in the VBS together. I don't know her name. When the proposal came and pastor said her name, I said, I didn't know. In the presence of God, I tell you the truth. Today when I see the way people behave with the matches, I don't know whether we were mystic people or not. There's no exaggeration, I tell you. Since I was a translator, probably she would have seen me. But not once, even there was one, no hello exchange. Do what you learn of your pastors. Anything negative, anything wrong that you could see in us, please forgive us and leave it. Anything spiritual, anything good that you could see in us, do it. Then God of peace will be with you. As I told you earlier, I don't have the grace to say, to stand in the level of Paul and say this. With all humility within my limits, I say this. And more than that, what you have learned, what you have seen from Paul, what you receive from Paul, do it. More than that, my final words, what you have seen, what you have learned, what you have heard from Jesus, do it. Shall we pray?